Respected Dr. Shri, Mayee, former chairman ASRB and chairperson of today's function. Dr. Radha Prasanna, principal scientist division of microbiology, recipient of Shri Hari Krishna Shastri Memorial Award. Dr. R.K. Jain, dean and joint director. Distinguished guests here, the head of the divisions, the project director, and also the principal scientists, the dear students. On my behalf and on behalf of IARI, I welcome all of you, especially Professor C.D. Maheji, and also the recipient who is going to deliver the lecture. Before I say some words, let me say a few words about the award itself, that how it was instituted. And before that also, I need to do honors by welcoming the chairperson of today's function. The Hari Krishna Shastri Memorial Award was initiated in the year 2000-2001 on the request of Srimati Vibha Shastri ji, wife of late Sri Hari Krishna Shastri ji. Sri Shastri ji, as we know, he was Minister of State for Agriculture and had contributed very significantly in the area of agricultural research by way of his support to the system and also the education. And more so in the field of field-related activities at the ground level. He was always a great source of inspiration and worked very hard for improving the quality of life for the common people. The purpose of institution of this annual award was to motivate agricultural scientists by recognizing their outstanding contributions to agriculture research, education, and extension in our country. The award carries a cash prize of ₹25,000 and a citation. We all know the chairperson very closely because many of us have been selected by you, sir, at different occasions. I also faced twice the board with you, chair, and I was fortunate to be successful. Dr. Charudat Digambar Mai received his graduate and postgraduate degrees in 1965 and 1967 from College of Agriculture, Akola, and PhD from IARI, New Delhi, in the year 1972, securing gold medal. Dr. Mayee is an excellent research scholar, able administrator, and educationist. During 35 years of service career, he served the Indian agriculture on various capacities like research. He also worked with MICO, research assistant in CRRI Cuttack, research associate, Ford Foundation, New Delhi, assistant virologist, PAU Ludhiana, and plant pathologist, Rice, at PAU Ludhiana. At MAU Parbhani, he served as professor and head, and thereafter also worked as associate director, NAB, Aurangabad, and vice chancellor for the year 1997 to 2000. He was the director of CICR Nagpur during 2000 to 2003. And during 91-93, he worked as Associate Dean PDKV Akola before being appointed as Agriculture Commissioner for the period 2003 to 2004 And later on in 2004, you joined, sir, as chairman of the ASRB. During his outstanding academic career, he has been decorated with several prestigious awards and recognitions, including the prestigious Alexander von Humboldt Fellow at University of Hohenheim, Stuttgart, Germany, from October 1980 to December 1981, and several other awards, and also the membership of the Indian Academic Society. An ardent researcher himself with an eye for perfection, Dr. Mayee guided a large number of students for advanced degree and published a large number of high quality publications. From a small and obscure place like Parbhani, he conducted a series of investigations on the major diseases of groundnut that drew international attention. His explanation on the epidemiology and host resistance disease management formed the basis of curtailing crop losses, increase in area, and increased domestic availability of groundnut oil. He established rupees 4.5 crore commercial tissue culture project at Parbhani in 1999 to 2000, and carried out the largest mega demonstration project on precision farming and cotton on 1000 hectare area in Parbhani. He established the first network project of rupees 2.5 crore on IRM in the country, involving 260 villages in 26 cotton growing districts. He has a long association with a large number of professional societies and various committees at national and international levels, and served them at various positions. For his outstanding research contribution and management of groundnut disease and development of technologies that have a direct impact on farming community, Dr. C.D. Mayee has been awarded the first Rao Bahadur Dr. B. Vishwanath Award for the Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi. So, with these words, I welcome you, sir, in this memorial presentation lecture. And I hope that with your guidance and your remarks, all of us will be benefited. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the Honorable Chairman of today's session, Dr. C.D. Mayee, to kindly introduce the awardee to the chair.
Thank you, Dr. Singh, for my introduction. I have pleasure of introducing today's award winner, Dr. Mrs. Radha Prasanna. As you see from her face, she is always prasanna. So I think it's a very good occasion that I am introducing her now. I joined Dr. Patil in congratulating IARI for having this kind of a system before the actual convocation as a week to have really good lectures, award-winning lectures, and also a good tradition that they called me and party like people who are retired, otherwise sitting at home. So I thank you for calling me for this function. Dr. Radha Prasanna is an alumnus of IARI and obtained both master's PhD degrees from IARI in 92 in microbiology. She joined IARI as a scientist in 96 and was elevated to the post of principal scientist almost about 6 or 7 years ago. She has 30 years of experience in microbiology, including development and evaluation of microbial inoculants, and successfully carried out various research projects. She has published more than 150 research papers, among which some of them have been some articles which are really of very high impact factor. She is recipient of various awards and honors, including the famous ICAR Punjab Rao Deshmukh Outstanding Woman Scientist Award in 2012, IARI Best Teacher Award, IARI Gold Medal for Outstanding Academic Performance in Microbiology. She is also fellow of NAS, member of American Society of Microbiology, and life member of Indian Science Congress Association and Association of Microbiology. When we look to her contributions, Radha Prasanna has made significant and pioneering contributions in the subject in which she has specialized. Developed number of effective and easy to use microbial methodologies and validated them for evaluating the integrated effects of microbial consortia. Demonstrated agriculturally very useful synergistic interactions among bacterial, cyanobacterial strains and novel biofilm formulations. She has also undertaken in-depth study of anabina strains and isolated from diverse rice-based agroecosystem. Utilized allele mining and bioinformatics tools for comprehensive characterization of selected strains, leading to identification and general involvement. Deposited more than 200 cyanobacterial and bacterial sequences in NCBI gene bank, very important contribution. Developed biocontrol formulation also and demonstrated their positive influence on the soil and crop microbes, leading to higher productivity. She actively is engaged in farmers' participatory program for field level demonstration. So I think if you see her biodata, she deserves this award, and I congratulate her for getting this Shri Hari Krishna Shastri Memorial Award, and we await for your half an hour lecture. You have promised, because if you can't tell in half an hour what you have received award for, is it worth telling them? Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I take the great pleasure in inviting the recipient of this year's Shri Hari Krishna Shastri Memorial Awardee, Dr. Radha Prasanna ma'am, to deliver her award lecture.
Distinguished guests, scientists, experts in the field, my dear and respected teachers, scientist colleagues, and Priya Chhatrigan. Today I am really privileged and feel really happy to be here telling you about my journey at IARI. I have enjoyed every moment of it, and I hope you will also enjoy with me what I have done. I feel extremely privileged to have been coming into this field of cyanobacteria under the tutelage of Professor G.S. Venkatraman and then with Professor B.D. Kaushik, with whom I worked for my MSc, PhD, and later he was the head of the division, and I am extremely privileged about that. And as you all know, cyanobacteria or blue-green algae or nil-harit shaiwal, they are known very well to people. But their use in various aspects of agriculture was less explored till the 1950s, when Professor Day, Professor R.N. Singh showed us that they have an important role to play in the nitrogen economy of usar land as well as rice fields. They are known to be the pioneers in various habitats, and therefore we wanted to look not only at their role in nitrogen fixation, which was well established, but also in various other aspects related to agriculture. So what are the questions that we set out asking? First is, can cyanobacteria survive and exhibit metabolic activity in the rhizosphere? Because they are photosynthetic, nobody thought they could live in the rhizosphere. Second, can we combine them with bacteria? And can we develop some microbial inoculants? And most importantly, can we look at them as inoculants for crops other than rice? Because all the work till that time has been done on rice. Cyanobacteria, as you might be very well aware, are also a source of bioactive metabolites. Well, you would be surprised to know that a single genus, Lingvia, is a source of more than 240 metabolites, and among which 75% is from a single species, Lingvia majuscula. But nobody exploited them for the use in agriculture. So we set out to look at these bioactive metabolites for their use as fungicidal agents. Another aspect that we have begun at IARI is the biofilm. Now, cyanobacteria, many of us who are working and do know that whenever we try to isolate cyanobacteria, you get a lot of bacterial contamination. So we know that they exist in the mucilage because cyanobacteria have mucilage. So why not use this mucilage as a niche for including other agriculturally important bacteria or agriculturally important fungi? So that was the premise that we took up. Then we decided to look at different carriers because we are using both photosynthetic and heterotrophic organisms together. And more importantly, in the last few years, we have been looking at whether the benefits of cyanobacteria inoculation is limited only to the improved nutrient uptake or availability, or does it modulate plant and rhizosphere microbial communities or the plant and soil microbiome. So keeping this in mind, the first study that we undertook was on the cyanobacterial diversity, which we surveyed a large number of locations under the ICRAP CESS Fund project. That's my first project. And we were able to develop a comprehensive database of cyanobacterial distribution and also identify hotspots. We isolated more than 160 strains, and among which our focus was on the anabina strains, which we isolated from diverse ECPH soils as well as diverse ecologies. And further, in order to understand their diversity, we also studied using molecular tools. And this is the first report on morphological, biochemical and molecular diversity of the genus Anabina. Now this was published in Microbiological Research and has received more than 32 citations to date. And also our cyanobacterial Anabina genus, the diversity within this, the morphological diversity, was depicted as the cover page for the Journal of Basic Microbiology in 2009. Further, now coming to the rhizosphere. That is a very interesting area because we never thought that we would get, and we were so happy, myself and my SRF and students. And we, to our surprise, found a large amount of growth of cyanobacteria, which we then isolated, characterized, and this is our publication on cyanobacterial diversity in the rhizosphere of rice. This was not accepted for 2 years. I went on, trying, because nobody would believe that cyanobacteria could live in the rhizosphere. Further, then we looked at yeast. This is one of our landmark papers evaluating the potential of plant growth promoting cyanobacteria as inoculants for yeast, because nobody had looked at yeast. This was done by one of MSc students of Dr. Kaushik, and we were able to show that the cyanobacteria enter into the root and they also promote growth. And further, they also produce IA, which is also in dark. If you see very carefully, it is also in dark. And this is the mode of entry of the cyanobacteria into the root. And we were also able to develop some markers. Cyanobacteria are unique in that they have certain palindromic sequences as well as short specific repeat sequences, which we use to develop fingerprints, which we use further to understand the colonization proficiency. And we selected four strains, which we carried out further work in field experiments, and were able to show that cyanobacteria colonized the rhizosphere. This is a very important aspect because most of the work on cyanobacteria has not flourished so much or not got into prominence because of the establishment problems. We were able to show conclusively that cyanobacteria do establish in the rhizosphere and in the soil. Now we also did some certain studies to corroborate the nitrogen fixation, which is acetylene reduction activity, or the ARA, and we were able to show that nitrogen fixation could be correlated. And to our knowledge, this represents the first attempt at evaluating agronomic, microbiological, microscopy and DNA-based attributes to understand fungibacterial efficacy. Coming to the next aspect which we looked at was on fungicidal activity. These bioactive metabolites, can they show fungicidal activity? If so, what is the reason behind it? So we looked at certain cyanobacterial strains, and we were able to show that they showed the activity of hydrolytic enzymes. And this showed a positive correlation with fungicidal activity. This is perhaps the first report in cyanobacteria regarding the presence of genes, the homologs for novel metabolites, hydrolytic enzymes such as endogluconases, chitokinases, and also certain molecules which were showing fungicidal activity. This is another of my students' work, wherein we were able to isolate a compound called as magistrimide C, which is fungicidal. This is one of my PhD students' work wherein we took this particular gene strain, Calyptics erythrinae, which was showing fungicidal activity. We were able to comprehensively show that right from what are the genes involved and also isolate a novel endogluconase with a signal peptide. We also showed that many of these strains contain several genes for these hydrolytic enzymes and fungicidal compounds. Now this further, in order to understand the regulation of these, we also looked at different factors and we found that phosphorus nutrition, pH, also play a role. Now coming to the most interesting aspect which I have enjoyed most doing is the development of cyanobacteria and bacteria consortia. So this we developed using rhizosphere strains from rice and beef, and we were able to conclusively show in phytotron experiments, net house, as well as in field experiments that these consortia really work. And this is one of our top cited papers in Plant and Soil, wherein we were able to show the synergistic effects of these two strains. I have enjoyed working. I particularly like to remember here that how we used to, Dr. Lata and I, we used to sit in the field on even on a Sunday morning and do the transplanting of the rice. We used to dip our in the cultures and do. And we did it for so many combinations of strains with Dr. Shire's help, and we were able to come out with very promising consortia. Another aspect is biofilms. Most of you all must be reading about biofilms. Most of them are of medical significance. However, we try to look at them for their agricultural significance. So the mucilage of cyanobacteria, as I told you, is very nutrient-rich. So we decided to look at agriculturally important bacteria such as Acidobacter, Rhizobium, as well as different fungi, including Trichoderma, whether they could be housed in that, could they grow together, could they form biofilms which could be used as inoculants. So in this, we were able to show that there was synergy in function, they were able to establish much better in soil, and they could be employed in as biofertilizers and biocontrol agents in a variety of crops. And they improved colonization in roots and increased germination by 10 to 12%, biomass, nodulation, as well as nitrogen and phosphorus mobilization up to harvest speed. Most of the microbial inoculants that we apply, mostly it is only till the mid-crop stage that we see. But with these biofilms, because they are able to stay in the soil for longer time, they are able to show such activity. And also they were able to show 10 to 20% increased biocontrol activity against fungal pathogens. Coming to these are some of the biofilms that we have developed. And these were also developed with Trichoderma as a matrix. And these have been used with carrier as peristraw compost and vermiculite. This is our major carrier which we use. This is my student who is getting his degree and was also awarded the gold medal this year. We try to understand how these biofilms form, what are the factors that actually improve biofilm formation, and for which he has also got the gold medal this year. Now coming to the different crops that we have done, this is a list showing you the various types of crops we have also undertaken. I'm very happy to tell Professor Mayee that we have taken experiments at CICR Nagpur as well as the CICR regional station at Sirsa, wherein we were able to show the plant growth promoting and the biocontrol potential of our inoculant. Now these were able to not only save nitrogen in terms of 25 to 40%, but they enhanced the availability of nitrogen and phosphorus in soil, and also the nutritional quality of grains in the rice wheat cropping system. Now this is our paper in which we have been first time we showed that microbial activity and through microbial agents we can bring about biofortification of grains. And this is one of the top cited papers. Not only can we breed for better varieties, but also if you try to breed for better microbial activity in the rhizosphere. That's why I always tell that breeders should also look at the underground as well as the roof, because there are lots of activities going on which can improve the variety. Also coming now, we try to understand, in the recent years you must have been hearing a lot about the microbiome, that is, what is the microbial population inside the plant, inside the soil, what do they do? So we try to understand it in a part of the MSc work of one of my students. We were able to inoculate the cyanobacteria and we try to understand the bacterial community, both the culturable as well as the unculturable data. We were able to show that cyanobacterial inoculation brought about distinct spatial and temporal changes in the PLFs and biomarkers indicative of the different communities that were influenced. We were also able to show through denaturing gradient electrophoresis that both PLFA and RISC were able to show finally that the cyanobacterial inoculation of the rice plant growth actually helps in maintaining the beneficial core microbiome of rice. Further, we also try to look at the phyllosphere. As you know, cyanobacteria are photosynthetic, so they would be living in the phyllosphere. Why not look at that area? So we looked at the phyllosphere microbiome, and we were able to show that there were different bacterial morphotypes along with certain cyanobacteria and fungi. As you can see, majority were belonging to the firmicutes and the proteobacteria. And this was published in Plant Biology. And now recently, my student who is going to get his degree, we worked on the diversity and abundance of microbial communities of the rice phyllosphere microbiome as influenced by different varieties as well as by the cultivation method. And we were able to show that distinct changes are observed as a result of varieties and also because based on the nutrients. Not only the leaf nutrients but also the soil nutrients. And these have been published already in two journals. Now coming to our inoculants in rice, which we have been doing for the last 8 years, and we have been able to corroborate that the nitrogen fixation or the ARA is actually corroborated with better growth, better root growth. And now recently we have been able to show that by quantifying the cyanobacterial 15S RNA, that there is an increased abundance in the cyanobacteria population whenever where we are inoculated. This is an additional, besides showing it in the root, besides showing it that they are pollinizing, this is our next result. Then we have also shown similar results with wheat, and there have been significant increases in nitrogen as well as soil polysaccharides, which help in soil aggregation, and these all positively correlated with the microbial activity and yield. These are some of our publications on rice and wheat cropping system, and I'm happy to say that we received a certificate for highly cited research on our first paper on biofilm biofertilizers, which we applied in wheat. Coming to maize, this is our, from 2014, we have been working with maize, and we were able to show that the highest yield was recorded with our Annabina Nostoff consortium, which we had all rhizosphere isolates, and we were able to show that they were able to increase 100 seed weight with a saving of 25% N. These were also shown through molecular tools using CLFAs, LRAs, as well as NIF gene copies. This is very interesting because I wanted to show here that the increase in nitrogen availability corroborated with the ARA or the nitrogen fixing potential. It also corroborated with the NIF hex copies in the soil. So we are able to show conclusively that our inoculation definitely helps in improving the nitrogen availability in the crop. These are some of our publications on maize. Coming to 60, everybody said, why are you working on 60? So we just felt that cyanobacteria could perhaps elicit better activity, better nodulation, and to our happiness, it was actually true. And we could see that cyanobacterial inoculation, particularly this strain, I'm really interested in because it actually improved leguminoglobin and also total nodule number, besides the Annabina rhizobium biofilm inoculant. We were also able to show significant increases in 100 seed weight as well as fruit protein. Similarly, in the nutrient availability of soil was also increased with a 12 to 15% increased yield and a savings of 20 to 30 kg nitrogen per hectare per season. These are some of our publications in CHICPI. Now, we have not only just been in IARI, we have also gone to ICR Regional Station Katran, where we undertook some evaluation for 2 years in sweet pepper, and we were able to show that the use of biofilm inoculants actually were able to increase yield and also reduce disease incidence. This is in protected cultivation. As you know, protected cultivation suffers majority because of the soil degradation due to continuous cultivation, as well as that atmosphere being a breeding ground for several pathogens. So in our IARI research project, we are conducting research on chrysanthemum, different flowers, as well as vegetables. And we were able to show through microbial community profiles, as well as quantitative PCR, besides the agronomic and microbiological tools, that cyanobacterial inoculation can definitely have benefits on plant growth, yield, and soil fertility. We were also able to show certain varietal effects. For example, the variety Zembla performed very well with our inoculants, and its use as a drench also performed equally well with improved nutrient availability in soil and improved crop yield, as well as flower diameter and flower quality. This is the 16S RNA, we had abundance which we did for archaea, cyanobacteria as well as bacteria, which showed that Zembla was the most responsive. We also have undertaken in different crops in capsicum, and as well as in tomato, wherein there has been a significant increase in the yield due to these inoculants. Coming to biocontrol, this was our earlier how we went about slowly. We first used culture filtrates, then we used microbe amended compost, then we used dry cultures, then now we have come on to the compost vermiculite. We also have used compost tea as a soil drench with and without seed dressing or seed dip. So this way we have proceeded right from my first MSc student, and now we are at this stage where we are using both compost tea as well as the formulation. And these were able to not only show suppression of the disease severity ranging from 6 to 30%, but also showed enhanced defense responses and improved plant growth. These are some of our publications, and this is very interesting because for 3 years we conducted the at CICR research station in Sirsa, wherein they were really happy with our inoculants. And as you can see, the germination in the 6 plots improved from, you know, use of 13% with trichoderma. With our biofilm, we were able to show 26% germination. These 6 plots actually had no plants at all, and our inoculants really proved very promising in all the 3 years. And there was about 10 to 12% lower mortality, enhanced nutrient uptake, as well as better yield. This is our previous, like we had done on mortality. Now we are using the copies of the fungal population to understand the rhizoctonia population. We thought, let us show that actually the disease is reducing. It is not just because of plant growth or improved microbial availability of nutrients. It is because there is a reduction in the fungal population. This we were able to show through quantitative PCR. And these are some of the technologies that we have developed through the years. It has been possible with the support of all the team, the entire team. We have developed a very simple protocol for nitrogen fixation, and this has been used not only in microbiology. I think most of the agronomy people, students, all use this technology for measuring nitrogen fixation. These are some of our other technologies. We have 3 technologies which have emanated from our work. One is the cyanonutricon, which is basically involves 4 cyanobacterial strains, which can provide 20 to 25 kilo nitrogen. This has been tested in various areas besides IARI. We also have a biofortification technology in which we have a cyanobacteria-bacteria consortia as well as bacterial consortia for effective micronutrient mobilization in grains. This showed 13 to 40% increase in iron, zinc and Mn, and also combined with increased yield and a 40 to 60 kg nitrogen saving per hectare. We also have a cyanobiocon, which is the 2 formulations with anabina laxa as well as with calostrix. We have developed a biocontrol formulation, and which we have also tested in various areas including Sirsa, Varanasi, as well as in Delhi, as well as we have shown that these are actually show a significant decrease in mortality. Now our work has not just been on microbial resources, it has also been part of plant protection, natural resource management, as well as frontier sciences and applied sector. These are some of our ICR news. And this is my favorite because I enjoy teaching, I enjoy nurturing young minds, and I have been involved actively in teaching and also guided 7 MSc students and 4 PhD students and currently guiding 3 PhD students. And it has been an immense pleasure because this is what gives me the kick to do more and do better work. I've been involved in several projects and 2 ongoing projects currently. As everybody says, this is perhaps my strength because I enjoy writing. And I enjoy writing stories, that's what one of my colleagues says. That is because, after all, research is a story. Why you want to do it, how you go about it, and interpret the results, and give some kind of a technology. So this is, we have a large number of publications. It is not individual effort, it is the effort of all my students, my SRF, my colleagues in the division and outside. And acknowledgement. My professor, Dr. Professor G. S. Venkatraman, Dr. B. D. Kaushik, I owe it a lot. My father is a very strict disciplinarian. So when I came to Dr. Kaushik's lab, I had a very smooth transition because he's very strict too. And I am also a strict one. So it's not the genes only, it is also the environment which modulates. I am extremely grateful to ICR, IARI director, former and present, and joint directors. Particularly, I would like to thank Dr. Malvika Dadani, JDR, who really encouraged me in my pursuit. My parents, my parents-in-law, my husband and son, who are the backbone of my success. Without them, I couldn't have done. Dr. Lata, my best friend, mentor, who helped me dream and aspire for the best. My colleagues, especially Dr. Anil Saxena, Dr. Ramakrishnan, Dr. Shive, Dr. Firoz, for supporting me through all my support, because I'm really a very hard taskmaster. So they've all helped me. And I also would like to thank Professor Prem Dureja, who's no more, but she started me on to the biocontrol aspect, because without whose help, I couldn't have gone forward. I'm also thankful to the facilities of the National Phytodrone. I think I'm one of the most prolific users. I think Dr. Arun and Dr. Ranjit Singh would vouch for that. And I thank the funding agencies. And I'm also extremely thankful to the semi-skilled contractual help. And it is said that the science of building new teams involves good leadership and followership, palpable shared commitment, and a terrific communication. Not only did my microorganisms show terrific communication and synergy in their activities, but I think myself and my colleagues together also had a similar kind of excellent communication and excellent energy coming out, which led to all this. And these are some of the teams which have, through the years, who have been a part of all my research. And I thank you. And I would like to end with the quote, which is one of my favorites, from Jiddu Krishnamurti: in oneself lies the whole world. And if you know how to look and learn, the door is there and the key is in your hand. Nobody on earth can give you either the key or the door to open except yourself. And if you remember a cult movie of our years, Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro, hum honge kamyab, kyunki man mein hai vishwas, aur pura hai vishwas, hum honge kamyab. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for your informative, interesting and scintillating lecture. A big round of applause again for Radha, ma'am. May I now request the chairman, sir. Yeah.
Dr. Radha has given a very comprehensive, and as I felt that she really, really deserved this award. She has been an excellent teacher also, it appears to be, from the way she has presented the entire panorama of cyanobacteria before us. I think I must congratulate you for this, and I never knew when I met your husband just on the roads of Addis Ababa that you are his wife. Otherwise I would have told him that she deserved already an award that time itself. Anyway, but one thing is, I think I must appreciate that IARI is already credited for the entire panorama of cyanobacteria. It was started, as you said, by Venkat Raman and then Dr. Kaushik and a lot of host of students. Otherwise, these particular organisms were actually more in the background. They were not coming into picture. But I'm happy that initially they were only looking into what we call it as nitrogen fixation abilities, and there are application, commercial application possibly, and that too only confined to rice. This is what is I remember. But I am very happy now that you have already explored those possibilities where it could be a very good plant protection agent. It could be a very good biofilm application. Not only other nitrogen, but it could be an excellent consortia group where it interacts with other bacteria and it can give a synergistic effect. I don't know whether it is mutualistic or it is only synergistic, but there are definitely, I think it appears from your presentation, that these are excellent activities already exist in cyanobacteria. And one thing which possibly I appreciated is that the extension from rice to wheat to chickpea and now also my favorite crop, cotton, where it is, I think it's very important that we use these things. But only problem what I feel today, that the research which has already converted into now few kinds of technologies, I think it needs spread. Because this again remains only confined. If you go beyond Delhi or beyond IARI, probably there is very less information or very less knowledge as such in SAUs about cyanobacteria. I think there is a need for this, and that could be possibly done by actually now promoting these technologies
on the wider uses in the crop system, particularly in areas where in dryland agriculture I am doubtful how much it can be useful, but at least where there has been a consistent rainfall above 800-900 millimeter, I think cyanobacteria can play a very wonderful role. I am really happy that I could come as a chairman and could also learn a lot of things about cyanobacteria from you, and that you are given this particular award. So I congratulate once again and say that kindly continue here. You have a lot of time and you have a host of students, and the work which Dr. Kaushik Venkatraman started, I think you can now culminate into developing more technologies which can be commercialized in future. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Dr. A.K. Singh, Director IARI, to kindly do the honors of presenting us all and a memento as a token of love and respect to Dr. C.D. Mayee, the chairman of this session. Thank you, sir. May I now request Dean, sir, to present a formal vote of thanks.
Distinguished dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, I'm sure I have justified the delay of a lunch by providing the three scintillating lectures which we had this forenoon actually. So I am fully justified by delaying you for today's lunch. Although we are certainly feeling the absence of Shri Shastriji's family members, Vibha Shastriji and her son, but I think wherever they are, they must be very happy to learn that IARI continues to remember Honorable Sri Shastriji's contribution to the field of agricultural research, education and extension. We are very grateful to Professor C.D. Mayee, chairpersons of today's session, for accepting our invitation and sparing his valuable time in attending this Memorial Award lecture. I'm also thankful to the distinguished guests who spared their valuable time and listened to the speaker and the winner of the prestigious Sri Harkishan Shastriji Memorial Award lecture. I also extend my thanks to Dr. A.K. Singh, Director IARI, for attending this memorial lecture and also providing me the valuable guidance in conducting this award lecture. I'm highly thankful to Dr. Radha Prasanna, the winner of Shri Hari Krishna Shastri Memorial Award, for delivering this very good lecture. I am really happy to note that she has really fully justified that she is really IARI's best teacher. I am highly thankful to all the guests, our joint directors, professors, head of divisions, faculty, and the students for their presence. Once again, I thank you all. And I request you all to please reassemble at 2:30 for the School of Social Science professor's presentation. Thank you so much.